Scams are a continually evolving threat, but there are some common themes and signs that are pretty timeless. Here is my list of 10 red flags that something might be a scam. None of the items in this list are absolute or definitive. The real world doesn't work like that. So for any of the red flags I list here, there will be genuine exceptions where something similar happened and wasn't a scam. But these are like the red flags at the beach. They don't guarantee you'll die if you go in the water, but they are a serious warning that you should wake up and pay attention to. Anyway, on with the list. Number 1. If it's unexpected. Your bank suddenly contacts you by email or phone about an important matter. A friend you saw only yesterday suddenly emails to say they've been arrested on the other side of the world. You get a message about a voicemail through a messaging portal you've never heard of. Or a complete stranger falls head over heels in love with you without ever having met you in person. Oh, this is all so sudden. Normal life is normal. Scams are an intrusion to normal lives, and so scams will often appear by surprise completely out of the blue. Number 2. If it looks wrong. Your bank, PayPal, Apple, Microsoft, Google, the United Nations, FedEx, UNICEF, and other organizations have entire departments dedicated to the task of creating clear and effective communication. So if you receive a message that purports to be from one of these sorts of big organizations, and it has even a single small error of spelling, grammar, punctuation, phrasing, or fact, this should raise a red flag. Of course, genuine mistakes are possible, even after the amount of effort these bodies expend on getting it right. So a spelling mistake is not an automatic guarantee that something's fraudulent, but it's something you should look for, and if you find it, your suspicion level should go up. Number 3. If it asks you to do something that's outside of the norm, like giving your PIN or other secret information to someone who asks for it on the phone, or a request to access your computer to help you with your online banking, or a supposed business or government agency that wants to be paid in the form of gift cards, or a simple parcel redelivery that asks for all of your bank and credit card and personal details. If someone asks you to step outside of established protocols for any kind of transaction or business, it's a strong indicator of a scam. Not only that, but if you comply, you're also increasing the risk that any loss you incur can't be recovered. As a mundane example, if you're selling an item on eBay and the buyer asks to complete the sale outside of the eBay system, using a payment escrow mechanism you've never heard of, not only is it likely a scam, but after you get scammed, you can't fall back on eBay's protections. Number 4. If it claims to be urgent. Some things in life are urgent, sure, but a very common indicator of scams is the threat of urgency, especially if the urgency is underlined with some dire consequence if the deadline is overrun. Again, it's possible for urgent warnings about bad things to be real, but in general, your bank won't just threaten to close your account unless you click a link. The Inland Revenue will not have you immediately arrested if you fail to press 1 on your phone handset. Amazon will not just tell you there's a fraudulent purchase on your account that they're going to allow to go through unless you resolve it. Scammers do this to trigger your self-preservation instincts, that part of your brain that might well have been useful in telling you to run if the threat was a venomous snake or a crocodile, but may cause you to run directly into a trap if the threat is an intelligent adversary who's set a trap for you. A scammer doesn't want you to stop and think because you might realize it's a scam. Number 5. If it claims to be secret. You've been selected to stand in as the beneficiary of some massive unclaimed fortune. You're told that you must keep it completely secret, so as not to arouse suspicion, or for whatever other excuse, you're told by a stranger to keep a secret. The most likely explanation is that it's a scam, and they don't want you telling anyone else because the more people you tell, the more likely it is that one of them will reply, "Hey, you know that's a scam, right?" Number 6. If it strenuously claims to be genuine. Think about all the genuine communication you've ever received from your bank, or from your phone company, or other businesses and individuals you've had dealings with. They never feel the need to assert something like, "This is your genuine and real bank, and the business we are about to discuss is 100% legal and risk-free." The more that someone, especially a stranger, tries to put you at ease that something is risk-free, legal, genuine, and real, the more suspicious you should probably feel that maybe it isn't. In general, a lie requires more effort to defend than the truth. Number 7. If it plays on your emotions or empathy. Dying widows whose spouse and children all died in tragic circumstances do exist in the real world, of course, but when someone you've never met brings up such a story early in a conversation as a reason you should do the thing they're asking of you, at the very least, you should realize that you're being emotionally manipulated. Now, I do know that genuine and well-meaning charity organizations also tug on the heartstrings in order to elicit support, and maybe it's not a bad thing to try to evoke a bit of human empathy. It's just something to take note of when it happens and apply appropriate caution and sobriety. Number 8. Unprofessional behavior. Scammers typically have a singular objective. They want to direct you through the shortest possible route to the point where they will get your money or control of your account or whatever else they mean to steal from you. Diversions tend to annoy them, and they're not always very well equipped to handle them. Customer service representatives from genuine banks and companies, on the other hand, are typically trained to respond patiently to questions and confusion on the part of the customer they're serving. If you're talking to someone who's supposed to be helping you, and they tell you to shut up, or they get angry, or swear, or shout, or threaten you with consequences, or just demand that you proceed without a clear answer to the question you asked, or any other breach of polite etiquette, it could be a scammer. It could also be a genuine customer service rep having the worst day ever. But if they lose their cool, like most things in this list, it's a red flag, and you should pay attention to red flags. Number 9, if it seems too good to be true. A bit of a corny aphorism, but pretty accurate in the real world. Don't get me wrong, amazing bargain offers sometimes do happen, and astounding acts of random philanthropy sometimes do occur, but they're very much the exception. If you see an expensive item on sale online at an absurdly low price, or a random stranger wants to give you a fortune, or has inexplicably fallen head over heels in love with you, it's usually not true because it's too good to be true. And finally, number 10, if you have to ask, it's a scam. This one also sounds like a corny aphorism, but surprisingly often the truth. If you saw something and you thought it might be a scam, and you went as far as asking an online community or an individual expert, is this a scam? You're probably asking because you've subconsciously picked up on a red flag, perhaps one of the ones I've already mentioned, and it's highly likely that the answer is yes, it's a scam. I get a lot of people asking me this question about something they've seen, and I've seen the same thing on discussion forums and communities. I can't remember very many cases where the thing being asked about was not a scam. If you have to ask, is this a scam? It's probably a scam. But it's not over. This list of 10 things actually goes to 11. A bonus red flag factor. Number 11, if other people are saying it's a scam. When people ask me, is this a scam? The first thing I do is say, if you have to ask, then it's a scam. The second thing I do is Google it. So, for example, someone buying an item on Facebook Marketplace asked me if the seller might be scamming them. They provided screenshots of what the scammer had written. I picked out a phrase from the written message and Googled it, enclosed in quotes for exact matches only. The search results contained numerous cases of other people in the exact same situation as buyers and receiving the exact same worded messages, which were tugging at the heartstrings and asking to complete the transaction in an unconventional way and mentioning eBay even though the item was being sold on Facebook, and going to great lengths to explain why it was genuine. So many red flags, but also so many other people all associating this exact message with a scam. And most importantly, in this specific case, across a considerable span of time, therefore the exact wording with the exact circumstances and pleading excuses can only be a lie. And the same is true if it's your own friends and family telling you that the thing you're doing is a scam. You really should at least hear them out. So that's my top 10 list of 11 red flags why something might be a scam. Did I miss anything? Let me know in the comments. Thanks for watching, stay safe from scams, and I hope to see you again soon.